In this video, I'm going to show you how to get Kali Linux installed on an Android phone. This is a Pixel 7 Pro running Android 14. This is a Samsung phone running Android 13. Both of them have Kali Linux installed as a rootless installation. Process is exactly the same. So as an example, on this phone, you can see that it's running Android 13. And on this phone, the Pixel phone, you can see that it's updated to Android 14. I'm also going to show you how to solve problems that a lot of people have had. People have had issues with phantom processes killing the GUI on a phone. So I'm going to show you how to solve that so that you can run KEX or the GUI version of Kali without any problems. My team and I have created a PDF, which I've linked below, that shows you this issue and then also shows you the full installation. So you can follow along with this video or download the below PDF and use that to help you get Kali installed. This is the easiest installation of Kali Linux on an Android phone. If you do a rooted installation, it's a lot more difficult, and I've covered that in separate videos, which I'll link below. Okay, but without further ado, let me show you how to get Kali Linux installed as a rootless installation on an Android 14 phone. So as mentioned, here we've got an Android 14 phone. This is a Pixel 7 Pro. First thing we need to do is install termux. You can get that from the FDroid store or you can go to GitHub. In this example, I'm going to use GitHub. Please note that on the official termux wiki, as well as the termux GitHub pages, we told that we shouldn't install the outdated version of termux hosted on the Google Play Store. As always, you install software like this at your own risk. You have to decide if you want to install this or not. I'm going to install the software from GitHub on this Pixel phone, but as always, you need to make that decision for yourself. So I'm going to open up Google Chrome and go to GitHub. The link is github.com/termux-app-releases. Once again, use the PDF below if you want to follow all of these instructions. Gives you a lot of information. What we're going to do is download the APK file. I'm going to click download anyway, exactly per the instructions in the PDF. I'm going to go to my downloads. I'm going to select the termux application, go to settings, allow from the source, and click install. We're now installing termux, which again is required for the installation. I'm going to allow it to send me notifications. And there you go, we've got that installed. We now need to run pkg update -y or -y. So I've typed the command and I'm going to press enter. Now when prompted, press Y so that you can install the package maintainers version. So press Y, enter. Press Y again, and just repeat that for the installation. Press Y, enter, Y again, and just do that multiple times as needed. Okay, so once that's done, we need to run the termux-setup-storage command. You need to do this in order to have shared storage, so you need to give termux storage access permission. This doesn't give it access to external connected devices, however. So command is termux-setup-storage. I'm going to allow it to have access to various folders. And once that's done, we need to install wget. Now, again, a lot of people have had problems trying to install Kali as a rootless installation on their phones. So we're covering a whole bunch of options here to make sure that you can get it working. So we need to install wget. So command pkg install wget, press Y when prompted. Okay, so wget is installed. And now using wget, we can download NetHunter and install it. So the command is wget-o install NetHunter termux, and then the link to Offsec's website. So press enter and notice the software has been downloaded and now we need to change permissions. So char mode or ch mode plus x install NetHunter termux, press enter. And finally now we can install NetHunter termux and press enter. So we've got various options here. I'm going to choose one, full installation, and press enter. Now this is going to take a while, so I'll speed up the video at this point. But for you, now is a good time to go and get a coffee or something while the installation takes place. It's going to take a while. If you asked to delete rootfs, say no. We don't want to delete rootfs, but that'll come up after a while. So I'll pause the video at this point and speed it up. Okay, there you go. It took it a while, but now we asked delete downloaded rootfs file. Answer is going to be no. So uppercase N, press enter. And there you go. We can now start NetHunter. either through the CLI, or we can use KEX to get a GUI. So commands would be NetHunter to start CLI. A shorter option would be NH. So just type NH to start NetHunter. You can also use NetHunter-R to use root privileges, or NH-R to use root privileges. You can set a KEX password by using the command NetHunter KEX password. You can start KEX by using the command NetHunter KEX, and then you can stop it by using the command NetHunter KEX stop. Okay, but now let's try and solve this problem that a lot of people have had when installing NetHunter. They get this debus error. So the first thing we're going to do is start NetHunter with root privileges. So NetHunter -R. And as you can see there, we've got NetHunter running, but we're running as root. We're going to use nano. I mean, you could use VI if you really wanted to, but we'll use nano to keep it simple, to edit the etc/resolve.conf file. So nano etc/resolve.conf. What we're going to do here is change the DNS server information. Again, this is a problem that a lot of people have had. At the moment, the DNS is showing as 127.0.0.53. Change that to, for instance, Google or another DNS server. So I've now changed the name server to Google 8.8.8.8. What we're going to do is press Control X to exit and Y to save the file and Enter to overwrite the file. So what we can do now to verify that is use cat. And as you can see there, once again, the name server is set to Google. So what we're going to do now is update our references. So apt update. So there you go, references are being updated. And again, to solve the problem, we're going to install the software, so debus x11, and press Enter. And there you go, the debus software is being installed. Okay, one of the problems a lot of people have had is that child processes are killed. So Kali will run for a while, and then it'll just be killed. So the GUI will crash, as an example. And that's because child processes are being killed, so now we need to stop that. So what I'll do is go to Settings, scroll down, go to About Phone, scroll down, and I'll press build number 7 times so that we can go into developer options so that we can become a developer. I'll put in my password, and notice we are now a developer on this phone. I'll go back and then press system, go to developer options. Right near the bottom, we're going to disable child process restrictions. Okay, so there we go. Now we want to install the App Store and get KEX running on this phone. Okay, so we can go back to NetHunter. I'll exit out of there, and we're going to run NetHunter KEX to get a GUI running. We need to put a password in, so specify a password. I'll just use a simple password and press Enter. I'm not going to set a view-only password. Okay, this is really important. Make a note of the port number, 5901. That's the port number that we're going to connect the GUI to. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is go to the App Store, so store.nethunter.com/en, and we're going to select Download Store App, Download Anyway. I'm going to go to my downloads, open up that file, install it with the package manager. I'm going to say Always, install the software, and select Open. We're told that the App Store is based on a previous version of Android. That's okay, so I'm going to press OK there. I'm going to click on the magnifying glass, allow it to send notifications. I'm going to search for NetHunter KEX, and this is the software that we want, VNC for NetHunter KEX. It's now being downloaded. Click Install. I'm going to go to Settings. I'm going to allow this. Press Install. Go back. Press Open. On my desktop now, notice I've got NetHunter here. I'm going to say OK. Allow it to send notifications. And now I can specify my username, which is Kali. Specify my password. I can now specify my port number, 5901. And hopefully I'll be able to connect. And there you go. Notice I've now got Kali NetHunter GUI running on an Android phone. This is a rootless installation. Once again, I didn't remove Android. So here I can select disconnect to disconnect my session. Notice I'm back in an Android phone. I'll open this up again, press connect, and there you go. I'm now in Kali, and I could run applications directly within the GUI, or I could just do it through the CLI if I preferred. If you want more information, have a look at the PDF, which I've linked below. Have a look at my website, have a look at the NetHunter website, the documentation, and also the link on GitHub with issues with Android 12 that can help you. But hopefully this video and the attached PDF has helped you get Kali running on your Android phone. As always, I'm David Bomble, and I want to wish you all the very best. If you enjoyed this video, please like it. Please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and clicking on the bell to get notifications.